Desert Star. I'm glad you were able to find it. Kizma will be glad too. Isn't it great when we work together to everyone's benefit? Look at this thing, though. Strongest gemstone I've ever seen. Unbreakable. But it's also clear it was fractured from a larger piece. Yes, I'd say it's definitely first world material. Probably broken by the Titans themselves. Seems most of the shards are in Polaris, though. Go tell Baba Yaga what we've discovered. Meantime, I promised to give the Desert Star to Kizma so she might see it restored to Mirage.
Borealis gemstones are shards of a larger crystal from the First World? That explains their value, but not Rasputin's purpose. There's something we're missing. I wonder if the Auroracle's riddle holds the clues to this mystery. She said land and sky would be sundered. Bartleby said something similar, yes? It's about Polaris, but what exactly does it mean? Our Eye Scholar, Tarek Hadfield, comes from Polaris. He's been trying to solve the riddle. Go see Tarek in the Hall of Thaumaturgy and work with him to get to the bottom of all this. Time is fleeting.
Finally got around to coming to see old Tarek, eh? That's fine. I don't take offense. I've got a thick hide, don't you know? You're the one who spoke with the Auroracle, aren't you? Amazing, isn't she? Went to see her myself once. It'd been a long time since those days. Her words inspired me to leave my people, to leave Polaris. That's what led me here. That's a story for another day, though, don't you know? I've been looking into this land and sky business. Turns out the idea came from mammoth tusk inscriptions made by Polaris's first inhabitants. I've traced the tusks to three caves back in Polaris. I'll mark them on your map. Get the tusks, and I'll translate them, okay? All right, then.
The cave smells of dried bones and sad memories. It seems a guardian has arisen to protect the cave's sanctity.
Thank you.
Beneath a thin layer of ancient dust, the tusk is strong and smooth. Strange characters are etched into its surface.